Alright, so assuming that after you perform the 5 back blow and the 5 chest thrust, this baby here turns unconscious. Okay, so immediately, first thing you do, do not panic. Alright, lay the baby down in a supine position as what we have shown you. Okay, on a firm flat surface. Okay, next thing, shout for help. Call the mommy or the daddy to call ambulance 995 and get an AED. Also, it's good to also bring along the first aid kit. Okay, so next thing that you do, palm on the casualty's forehead, two fingers, lift it up, and then you trace the landmark. So how do you trace the landmark? Same thing, place one finger at the lipper line, two fingers beside the finger itself, then you compress. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 10. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 15. 1 and 2, 3 and 4 and 20. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 25. 1 and 2, 3 and 4 and 30. After 30 chest compression, check whether the mouth there's any foreign objects. So let's say there's any milk powders or chunks of milk powders. What we do, we use our little pinky, scoop out. Okay, the food or the milk powder itself. Next thing that we do, we check for the casualties, breathing. Okay, because we hope that after removing the foreign object, the baby regains consciousness, starts to breathe again. So what we do, we check for breathing. We look for rise and fall of the chest. Now, there is no rise and fall of the chest. It symbolizes two things. Number one, either the airway is still blocked by the foreign particles, by the food, by the milk powder, so on and so forth. Or number two, that the baby's lungs have collapsed. Meaning to say that the baby's lungs have stopped functioning. Okay, so how do we check and how do we know whether the casualty lungs is still functioning or the airway is blocked? We give two ventilation. Okay, so head tilt chin lift on the casualty's forehead, two fingers lift it up. Right, then take a face shield. Right, take a face shield, put on the casualty's mouth. Okay, and then you blow. So assuming first blow, there's no rise and fall of the chest. You know that the baby is not breathing. So what do? Reposition and re-head tilt chin lift. Put the baby head back and then lift it up. Because you're assuming it's your own fault, okay, you did not do a proper head tilt chin lift. As a result, the airway is still not open. Okay, so you assume your own fault first. Right, next, you give a blow. So let's say now the baby has rise and fall of the chest. The baby is breathing again. You will know that the airway is actually clear. Okay? The new protocol states that you only need to give one ventilation to confirm. Okay? So as you blow in, there is rise and fall of chest. You know that you are safe. Right? You know that the airway is clear. So what do you do? You take out your face shield, look for rise and fall of the chest. Okay? You see whether there's any rise and fall of chest. And if you are trained, if you are confident, do check for the pulse as well. Okay? So you look. Two scenarios, or rather three scenarios. Number one, there is no pulse, there is no breathing. What do you do? Start CPR, yes. Okay, so trace your landmark and then start CPR. Second scenario, where there is pulse but no breathing. What do you do? Rescue breathing. Okay, this is what we taught you earlier. Place your face shield on the casualty's mouth, head tilt chin lift, and proceed to rescue breathing. How you do? Okay. 2,000, 3,000. 2,000, 3,000. For 20 times. Rescue breathing. The third scenario is that when you check for pulse and breathing, both are present. You are happy because you save a baby's life. Before you celebrate, check the baby's any external injuries. Okay, and then put him on a lateral position. So how do you do? Tilt the baby to one side. Okay, you can either use your hand inside and support the baby or put a blanket underneath or cradle the baby like this. Okay, this will help prevent the tongue from falling backwards and any vomiters can also flow to your side. Okay, so let me recap the steps that I've shown you for unconscious infant choking. First of all, place the baby on a supine position, firm flat surface. Second, shout for help. Ask somebody or the mom or the daddy to call ambulance 995. Get an AED and get a first aid kit. Next, head tilt chin lift and start your chest compression for 30 times. After you perform chest compression, check the casualty's mouth whether there's any food or any particular foreign bodies seen in the mouth. Okay, so you head tilt chin lift, look, see whether there's any foreign bodies seen in the mouth. If there is, use your pinky, sweep it up. Do not ever do a blind sweep if you do not see anything, because this may push the foreign object back into the casualty. Okay? So next thing, after you scoop out the food, to check whether the airway is still blocked or the lungs have collapsed, you check for casualties, breathing. Okay? So you look for rise and fall of the chest. So there's no breathing, that's when you suspect the airway is still blocked. Okay? How do you determine whether airway is blocked or it's because the airway has collapsed? You give two ventilation, very good. Okay, so you give stool ventilation, you see whether there's any rise and fall of the chest. Okay, so in this new protocol, you only need one confirmation blow. So when you blow into the casualty, you see one chest rise. It means that the casualty's airway is clear. Right? What do you do next? Reassess casualty's pulse, casualty's breathing. Okay, so again, if there's no pulse, no breathing, what do you do? CPR. If there is pulse but no breathing, what do you do? Rescue breathing. If pulse and breathing is present, what do you do? Check for rescue breathing, check for any external injuries, and you put the babies on your left lateral position like this with the blanket underneath. Okay. Please remember to take note to support the casualty's neck, because the casualty's neck is still very fragile. Alright, so this is how you perform infant unconscious choking protocol.